Go.
Leave.
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 I hate
go.
Thank you.
No, all over.
All around.
Okay, any one thing that you enjoy?
Playing football.
Okay. And your name?
And my name is Sujan.
Sujan?
S-U-J-A-N.
My name is.
And one, any one thing that you enjoy?
Okay, my name is Apurva and I enjoy cooking for other people.
Wow.
My name is Falguni and I like to read books.
My name is Antara and I like to play with dogs.
So my name is Shammi and I like to eat good food.
My name is Aisha and I like to
play. My name is Zara and I like to be in the garden.
My name is Rujan and I like to play football.
My name is Nikhil and I enjoy my sleep. Me too, that too. Yeah, my name is Keiko and I love wildlife family.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you are telling sleep. And they were telling, you are telling wildlife.
Yeah.
It's not same.
It's
wildlife.
I like to sleep too.
Dude.
When I'm not in the forest.
But you said wildlife.
He likes to see like lions which are sleeping.
Yeah.
Some of you know this workshop is about what?
Non-violence.
What is non-violence?
Non-violent communication.
Do you know what is this workshop about? What does it mean?
Non-violent means how to talk.
Can you speak
speak
and then I'll hear you? What?
Be able to speak so that others won't get
confused. And what about you? Yeah.
What they say anybody else if we don't understand? In this non-violent communication, we learn how to say, how to understand, or how to speak when anybody is sad or happy or like this.
What about you? What did you understand about non-violent communication?
When we speak, so that the other people don't get hurt.
So how to have care for other people when we speak? What do you understand by
how you take into consideration other people's feelings, other people's needs, and then react in every situation.
Give other people a chance, you are saying everything. Give other people a chance.
I'm sorry.
So can you go this side? You want to go that side? Okay.
So for me, non-violent communication is something which connects people.
Oh.
Similarly for me, it's going beyond the surface level of communication and going deeper and really understand what people are saying.
But I want to learn that how to talk but not to make anyone sad.
For me, non-violent communication is how to talk to people who are sad and you don't want to say something to them so that they feel awesome.
And for me it's about when people are saying difficult things, they're getting angry, try to see what is it happening inside them, why are they angry, why are they in pain, what are they wanting, and try to see that everybody has something beautiful inside them and try to find that beauty out. What is it that you find difficult? Where do you get stuck? Is there any story where you were really wanting to communicate to somebody and somebody didn't understand you? Or there was some pain happening with somebody in your interaction with somebody? Anybody wants to share something?
When we see other things, we are like this or that. And when anybody say like, which we don't know thing. And they're saying, when we don't understand. So we get just angry, why I don't know this, why, just I can't see, like I'm saying.
Like what happened? Did it happen with somebody else?
Yeah.
What happened with whom?
When I was born, to other place where everybody was like difficult English. Can't understand what they are saying. I just tell yes, no, yes, no. What they are saying, I just don't know how to speak. Or when I tell something, they don't feel angry or sad.
So you mean to say you were speaking Hindi and they were speaking English more?
No, I was also speaking English.
But they were having difficult English?
Yeah.
And they were not understanding you? Something like that?
When my mother's YouTube, there are lots of English and difficult videos. When I see that to learn something, they are just saying what I can't understand and I can't change that language.
And then how do you feel when you can't understand?
I just feel angry and sad.
So you want to like learn things and so that you can understand it and enjoy that. It's Marshall Rosenberg, and he was looking at why do people act violently, and why do some people even in violence don't act violently? What helps us do?
When I have a fight with my brother and I want to explain to my mother what exactly happened, and I get so irritated that I don't know how to explain.
So how do you explain?
I don't like words to do, so I just don't really like find out what to say.
So that time really is irritating, not frustrating.
Yeah.
Your brother is also irritating and your mother is also not able to understand what you are saying.
Yeah, and since my brother cries for everything, and that's why it becomes like it's my fault. Because he's crying and I'm crying.
So it is like just, so you would want in that times to be seen that he's crying but he must have done something, which I did something, and you want to be understood that what did I do.
Exactly.
So do you sometimes feel that in that time your mother is not able to listen to you or understand you?
And I think my brother is crying too much for
not hearing. Oh, so his voice itself is so loud that she can't hear. And even if she can't hear, maybe her heart goes for the brother because she sees him in pain. And she tries to understand you also?
Yeah.
And how do you tell your mother, for example, last time when your fight happened?
I tell her after the fight is over.
After the fight is over?
Like yesterday, we first had a fight. Mm-hmm. We're playing tug of war and then mama was saying so I left the rope and he was down
and fell down.
Then, so after the fight finished, I told my mother.
After the fight finished, what did you tell your mother?
That he only told me to leave, so I didn't tell him. He was not pulling. So I told him he was not pulling.
So the mother could understand. So mother could understand. And are there some times where you try to explain and the mother doesn't understand in those times also?
That happens when I'm not able to find the words to say.
So can you tell me what words you are saying which is difficult? So give you an example. If you tell me what words you are saying, then I can tell you what could be different words in which you can say. For example, something happened and you are not able to find words. So according to Marshall, you know, he said that when you are in pain or something, you experience some feelings because we have some needs. Because when we want something and we don't get it, we get angry or frustrated. So if you want to tell somebody that I'm angry, you can also tell them I'm angry because I'm wanting food, or I'm wanting to take rest right now, you know, or I'm wanting someone to hear me and understand me. So often what happens is when we are angry or hurt, we keep saying, you are wrong, you did this, you know. So instead of saying that, we start trying to say, what is it that I want, you know. So can anybody think of a situation where you were angry or frustrated or...
A few days later, I was saying to my mother, but she's not understanding, I get angry. I'm saying, but she's not understanding what I'm saying. I want to sleep, but she's not understanding me. I was doing like, please let me sleep. She's not,
She's telling go out and play. I played 3 hours for cricket. And I'm so tired. I want to sleep for 1 hour. So I get more energy. She's not just listening to me.
So sometimes you're wondering why is my mother not able to understand?
Yeah, because that time she go for shopping. Then I was playing, so it's not her also fault. She didn't see me playing.
So you can also understand why the mother couldn't understand you. So that is other part of it, you know, that like whenever something happens, we have needs. But when somebody else is angry or disturbed, we try to see what are their needs. Like you just said that, you know, my mother didn't see and she maybe wanted you to have fun or wanted to enjoy things. And that's why she wanted to have some outdoor activity, and that's why she said go out. But sometimes it's difficult when older people or your mother in that time is not trusting what you are saying. Is it about that? You want her to trust you? That what you're saying is true? Any feeling that happens, like joyful when happens, because some of my need is met. So if it's joyful, which need you think is met, that's why I'm going to feel joyful. Try to see the connect the blue, which blue card you can get.
Fun and play.
Yay! Fun and play. So when my need for fun and play is met, I can raise my volume now. Okay. Because the mixer is playing there. So when the need for fun and play is met, then it's perfect. Okay, this is one pair. Okay, how? When can I feel content? Which of my need is met when I'm feeling content? Friendship. Okay, try another one. You pick up anything. Yes. When will you feel hopeless? When some need is not met. When something is not, you're not getting something. What is it that you don't get and you feel hopeless?
I think acknowledge.
Okay. So can you say?
Support.
Okay. When you don't get support, you feel damn hopeless. Care. Care is a need, okay? Try to pick one pink one and try to see. Sara, what is, can you read them?
Happy and creative.
So you feel happy? When your need for creativity is met. Wow. You feel hurt? And which of your need is not met? Right? See from the blue ones.
Okay, I got
what you don't get, which, let him see this one. So,
when you get hurt, he doesn't not get.
What is that you want which you don't get? Like, for example, love. When you don't get love, you feel hurt. So find also a need with it. Which is, what are you not getting, which is making you feel sad? Friendship.
I get irritated when I don't find any of my belongings.
Oh, any of your belongings, things, yeah? Yeah. But this belonging, when they say, which means belonging, meaning I belong to friendship, I belong to community, I belong in that sense. But when you don't get your belongings, like when your things, then you feel irritated. I understand that. Guruji Marshall said, very simple, and he's as, like, you people are, yeah, I mean, he's as intelligent as you, I'm just seeing, because I'm really impressed at how simply you're connecting so easily. So he said that all our feelings are connected to needs. So he said when you're getting angry, because you have a need. And when you have a need, for example, can you take out now? You felt sad because you have a need for friendship, okay? And one more thing he said, you have feelings, needs, and when you have a need, how do you get to your need? By making a request.
Oh, yes, I should.
So if you have a need for friendship, yeah? You have a need for friendship, you said?
Friendship with sad.
Yeah, that's okay. But you felt sad because you want friendship, okay? And if you want friendship, what is it that you can do? What request you can make to somebody else which will get you friendship?
I can tell, I won't do that again. Try to do this.
Tell whom?
Huh?
Tell whom?
Like
tell a friend? Okay, so you can go to a friend and tell them, a friend who's angry with you, that, hey, I want to play with you. Something like that? And I won't do that again? Yeah, so if you have, Can you?
When I get enough rest, I feel very optimistic.
Yeah. Okay. And what about you?
I feel hopeful when I get killed.
Yeah. What about you?
I feel bored when I don't have friendship.
So if you have need for friendship, what can you do? It will take you towards friendship. It's important for us. So our dear Marshall says that we don't get things because we don't make requests. So if we make requests, we will get things. Because request is a way that you go to somebody else and say, I want this. And you can make a request to yourself also. That if you're hungry, I can make a request that I'll go to the fridge and take out an apple and eat it. So you can make a request to yourself also. Can you share something?
I feel energetic when there's a celebration.
Yeah, great.
What?
She feels healthy. Say it again, loud.
I feel energetic when there is a celebration.
You want to say something?
So, if I don't have safety, if I'm not in safety, then I feel uncomfortable.
What do you feel up? Can you explain what you mean?
When I go to amusement park,
yeah.
It's like height, a big roller coaster come high somewhere.
Yeah.
So it's like a all like joy in a class. So I can only go there. So I'm not tall and I'm feeling upset. Why am I not there that much?
Okay.
I can't go on that because I was asking my mother, can I go? Can I go for 2 weeks? And she told me, and I can't go there, my favorite ride.
Because you are small right now, you have to grow up, something like that?
He must be. It's not as tall. It's not the height.
Yeah, that comes like, when we are that much only height, we can go on that.
Okay. So when you exactly don't have, when you don't grow enough tall, you feel upset. And people don't understand you or don't accept. But the other part is that whenever we are with somebody, they also have needs. So whenever a fight happens or a conflict happens, it is not because just we have needs, because others also have needs. So how can we find ways where we try to understand other people's needs also? So if it's a situation where, like for example, Sujan said that, yeah, I understand my mother also was not there, so she didn't know. She didn't have the clarity, you know. She was confused. So if you can try to see something that happened with somebody else, where they got angry, and you are unhappy about it, but try to see why did they get angry, what were they wanting? Is there some time where you can think of somebody and try to see? Yeah.
My friend, when I was going to village, I see you first. When I gone to village, my friend, his name was Lukesh.
Mm-hmm.
And he gone, we played, I said you one man came. We played and we go back home. Then he also wanted to rest. So I just go at his home to ask something. And he was angry. He's taking the angry on me. He's just being angry on me.
What was he doing?
He was just telling, why you come here? Go, I don't want to talk with you. But what I did, I don't know. I just play with him, I go.
But now you also said that you understand now that he was wanting rest.
Yeah.
And that's why he was irritated.
Yeah.
Just as that day you were irritated.
Because
when
he
you
said that tomorrow. Okay, I want rest and because I got angry, sorry. So
he told, next day he came and told you I wanted rest that day. So what is what I'm trying to say, even when somebody is angry, if you try to see what are they wanting and if you get to know that, then you will not feel so bad. Because you know they're angry not because I am doing something wrong, because they are wanting something. Like Sujan understood that his friend was getting angry or irritated because he wanted rest. So even if he says, stupid Sujan, why are you doing this? It won't hurt me so much because I think, you want rest, my friend.
Like many times, I feel sort of the shambles from the aunties downstairs and stuff. So I haven't done anything and the younger children go and complain sometimes that she's hit me a little and I don't do it. Not hit me, but she hit and they're like, she's bossing over me and stuff and I don't do it.
And even what you're doing is just trying to tell them don't do this and don't break this so that
yeah.
So that others don't blame you at that time.
Yeah. But then in
So what is happening is that when they go and say ki Sara is bossing, so one more thing Marshall says that there's a difference between interpretation and observation. So that is their judgment that you are bossing, but behind bossing, what is the observation is that you are just telling them that, hey, can you stop playing there because that car is going to break, you know, this gets scratched. So what you say, they make a story out of it. So that's our other habit. That whenever something happens, we make a story and we say you are wrong and you're slow and you always arrogant. And so behind every such story, try to see the need. Even if you have a story that about your mom, that yeah, mom is really like, you know, mom is maybe you can say mom is always shouting at me. You know, suppose, if you think like that. So rather than going and telling your mom, mom, you're always shouting, you can say, mom, that day you spoke in a loud volume. So if you say like a blame language, people don't like it, you know. If I say you are bossy, but if I come and tell you, oh Sara, you told me to not play there and I didn't like that. You see the difference? What is the thing when I say you are bossy and I say Sara, when you said don't play, I don't like it. What is the difference in these two lines?
Bossy is not like, bossy doesn't make the person feel
it makes them feel like blamed. Like they not they think that they are being blamed, but they feel frustrated and that they don't feel understood. But if you say, Sara, you know, ask me to stop playing next to the car because it's gonna get scratched. So that makes you feel better, huh? So whenever somebody comes and says, you have been bossy, you can focus. Wait a minute, what did I do? Are you talking about the time when I asked you to not scratch the car? Okay. Even if some child's parents come and say, oh, my child, son said you're bossy. You can say, auntie, what exactly did I do? Can you tell me and remind me, please? You think that would be easier for you then?
Yeah, but then still it feels odd to say, can you remind me? Because then sometimes the aunties are like, you know what you did and...
They don't understand that. Sometimes very challenging.
And for their children, they're shouting, and they like my mother doesn't shout, but when their children get shouting from other aunties and stuff, then they take the side of their children. And even when I'm getting shoutings, all the mothers and stuff are over there with their children and, you know, hugging them and stuff. And I'm right in the middle of everybody and their shouting. And it's difficult to move away if that does.
So now when Lara is saying this, you people guess what is her need, the blue ones, you know? And she's saying that, you know, I want them to see I was not shouting. Which is her need? Can you look at the blue ones? Understanding? You found it here? Okay. So now you ask her that, Sara, you want understanding? Ask her like that. And you want to say more to it?
I want understanding and I want people to say the same thing but in a better way too.
Okay, so when she says I want people to say things in a better way, what is she wanting?
I want people.
Okay. So ask her. Whenever you pick a card, you ask her.
1 second.
Sara, is this, you want this?
Yeah,
you want,
pick up,
you can also ask her that. Yeah. And can you take a close up of this one for a second? And
this one is
which one?
Falguni,
which one? So ask her, Sara, is it important for you to be seen? Ask her.
Yeah, not to be seen by the eyes, but to be seen by the heart.
Okay, can you take this? Can you take this again, Sara? So, Sara, you, what Falguni is saying there? Falguni, can you say it?
To be seen, to be understood.
Okay, what did you say?
So, I don't want to be seen by eyes. I want to, but it's not that important. But I would like it more if I was seen by the heart.
Okay. So, heart is something really beautiful, you know? And, yeah, so actually, Marshall also says that, you know, NBC is the language of the heart. And he even uses giraffe as an animal, which is a symbol of NBC. Maybe next time when I come, I'll bring some puppets. And why he says that? Because he says giraffe has the biggest heart in all the land mammals. It just pumps so much. So what are you talking of? Second, the heart. So heart is really important.
that is much more important for me than the
book. How are you feeling right now when you've been understood by Falguni and Sunil? Others. So that's the other thing that we give you. If one of your friend comes and tells me, you know why, you know, my parents are like this, or my friend is doing this and this, try to understand and see. So is it that you want trust? Is it that you want? And this in MBC we call empathy, you know. So when people get empathy, and empathy is like oxygen, you know. Even if you're not getting what you want, but if somebody can hear you, even if their aunties don't hear, but Falguni can hear you, you say, ah, somebody understands me. That's what's important. So I guess we have only 1 hour, and I wanted you to see one film by an Iranian filmmaker, and then we'll talk a little bit about the film.
Just at the level you get the thinking and you get the feeling, and yeah, I feel I'm a little handicapped when it comes to that, and it just really, I almost teared up when I heard all of you talk, so thank you.
It was really beautiful for you to hear when she said, I don't want to be seen by the eyes, but I want to be seen by the heart.
Absolutely. I mean, to feel that and then to have the vocabulary to say that, so yeah. You guys are an interesting bunch.